Composite Viewers, we started off our session in the morning at Poonskop. The sea got up overnight, so it was basically unfishable. Couldn't get off the point there, so we decided to come into the river and do some light tackle fishing for grunter, garrick, or cob. We've got some live bait, not the best, but we can make it work. We've got some pinkies and mullet. I'm just tying a straight 6-0 tuna circle onto my leader, 0.70 leader straight, and I'm just going to drift a live bait. We anchored here close to the mouth, and we're going to give it a bash and see how it goes. Sure. Got my live pinky here. Just going to pin it behind the head with a 6-0 circle, not too deep. You want the gape of the circle to be open if that garrick picks it up. Simple as that. I'm going to let it swim. I'm going to let that pinky drift around. Hopefully a garrick comes and swallows it.
Alright viewers, okay, so as Linton reckoned, we're here in the lagoon. Sea got really bad, so we decided to come and have a little session here. So what I've done is basically, this is how I fish for garrick in Richards Bay, but we're going to try it here in Port St. John's. So I've got a little bead, I've got a swivel that runs up with my balloon, and then I've got a little weight, and then my trace line for my pinky, right? That's your bait there. So what happens is, that balloon's going to slide up and stop at my leader knot there. So it's going to hold that bait at about, I don't know, 1.5 to 2 meters. And then the bait also has some freedom. Once something picks up that bait, it's going to pop that balloon. The cotton's going to pop there, and then you're going to go off with the fish. So that's the plan. Let's see if it works here. I'm not sure if it does or if it will. It's very shallow here. We're fishing in about 2 meters of water. The water is still low. So hopefully on the push, the water starts to rise a bit, the level rises, and then we'll start to get a better chance. But for now, we're just going to sit these baits out and we'll either throw a bucktail for a garrick or we'll do some grunter fishing and stuff like that. Alright, so guys, what we've done is we've taken Nash with us on the boat today. He's a really passionate angler. He's a young man, he's 14 years old. As you can see, he's fully kitted out with his Daiwa kit. He's got his Daiwa Procaster, he's got his Daiwa estuary rod. So Nash, how are you feeling today, boy?
Feeling great. Hopefully catch some fish, a few grunter, a few garrick, maybe some other fish.
Okay, and how long have you been fishing as a...
I started when I was 3 years old, so 11 okay. years.
So you've been fishing from the time you were a little kid.
Yeah.
And what's your best catch that you've caught?
It was a rock art of 18 kilos.
Oh, beautiful. And your dad, does your dad fish as well?
Not as much.
Okay. So guys, we got Nash with us and we're hoping to put him on a fish today. He's been with us on the trip and I've seen him fish. He's a really great angler. He's also asked a lot of questions, which is great. That's what we try to do. We try to develop the sport and get the youth involved. So Nash is gonna catch himself a 5 kilo garrick and a 10 kilo cob and hopefully a nice size grunter. So hang 10, watch out for Nash. Okay guys, we just had a pick up on that pinky. It popped the balloon. We're just waiting for it to go a bit, and it's going a bit now. Just gonna feed it a bit. Just hope it's an edible. Here we go, it's starting to move a bit. It's moving very slowly, so I'm not sure what it is. But it's coming forward. Okay, there we go, hooked him. Okay, we'll get a
ID on it just now.
got an ID just now. We're just gonna take it easy. We're just gonna, oh, nice fish. It's moving lekker. Have a look there. Alright. Okay, so that was on the live pinky and the balloon rig. I've got a light Kingfisher Poseidon Strike Force. Unfortunately, we didn't really come tackle to fish in the estuary. So I had to chuck my Saltiga 50HA on here. And I'm a bit overgunned. I've got 5.2. So I think it might be a Garrick. I got a small idea it could be a Garrick, but let's see. I mean, you yeah, know, it's right here next to the boat now. Port St. John's Garrick. Little one, not too big. You see the Garrick comes up and it shakes its head and it tries to throw the hook. So this one's almost done. Oh, there we go. So little Garrick. So there we go, guys. This is what we came here for. This is a little juvenile Garrick. So remember, they come up and down this river to spawn. That one swallowed the hook, so I'm gonna ask Nash to just pass me a... I'm not gonna try and take the hook out, but I'm gonna ask Nash to maybe just... we'll just clip the line off. So guys, this ate the live pinky. Not a huge Garrick, it's a little one, but nevertheless, still a Garrick. Nice to get an edible here in Port St. John's. This is probably 3-4 kilos if I'm lucky, but... I think with a lighter tackle, it would have been quite lekker. So, yeah, just chop that off there. Okay, so he swallowed the hooks. So we're gonna let this guy go. We just took a few snaps of this Garrick. I kept it in the water. Nice little fella. I hope he lives. I cut the hooks off. So we're gonna release this guy. We want to sustain this fishery and let him grow nice and big. So we can catch him one day when he's about 20 kilos. So let's hope this guy survives. He's ready to go back already. There we go. Okay, so yeah, that's what we came for. We came to catch a Garrick or a Cobia in the lagoon. It didn't take long. That bait was in the water probably half an hour, and that Garrick jumped on that pinky. So seems like the balloon trick worked and it kept the bait high enough. So yeah, let's try and put another bait. We got way less bait. We'll just try and put another bait and see if we can get another one. Lekker. Garrick, take two. Again, same rig. Little pinky with a little 5-0 mustard soy ring hook. Let's try again. Let's just try and get this one out. I throw a little red eye head. Got a double hook trace here. I throw a red eye head and a piece of sod and got a fish on here. Oh, this is something different. So I got a mullet on that head. I threw a red eye head, a big mullet. Oh, there we go.
Onto
the low
bit.
Okay, so just goes to show that you can catch anything here. I had a red eye head. Oh, there's a head, so I took the cutlet and on a little small mustard bait holder there, and a good sized mullet in the estuary. This estuary is it's got a lot of mullet. And obviously the cob and Garrick come in to breathe in here, and they come and char the smaller version of this. I'm sure you get bull sharks in here, and that'll probably eat this thing. So like a size striped bull mullet there, and nothing wrong with that. Good fight on the light tackle. I think these guys are very strong, so if I put him in the water, he's gonna shoot off very quickly. There we go. I've had two chances already. It's time for Nash and Linton to have their chance now, so I'm gonna try and slow down. I'll try. Shot.
We're driving past a spot called Big Tree at the Amzimvubu in Port St. John's. This is one of the best grunter spots if you want to come fish for light tackle grunter fishing here in Port St. John's. The reason being the channel is so close to the side. I mean, Dean, what's the depth?
2.5 meters.
We're 20 meters from the side and we're 2.5 meters deep, so it's a good spot to target grunter and cob from the side if you don't come here with a boat. It's easily accessible. You park your van in the side of the road and you can fish, and it's just a nice spot, so look out for that spot if you're coming down here. We just ended off our session on the river here in Port St. John's. It was quite a slow session. Got one garrick. Dean got a good sized mullet, and there were no other bites. We tried for smaller fish and tried for grunter and stuff, but it was a bit quiet. So we're going to head back now. Go to throw some paddle tails in the evening, and we'll catch up with you guys later. Shot.